Do girls need liberation? This is a very hot topic about liberation, and it's a very sensitive topic also. Based on the current issues where many women, based on the facts of the past, where the culture has been misunderstood, because of that culture being misunderstood, many women have been exploited in a wrong way, just using those statements of the culture. The proper culture, Srila Prabhupada explains, and our ancient scriptures explain, is that woman, a girl, needs to be protected at every step. Not as slaves, but as an asset. She's like an asset. So, as a girl, she's protected first by her father, then she's protected by her husband, and when her husband takes a renounced order of life, she's protected by her son. If she has any son, otherwise she is always protected by her husband. So this woman liberation, there has been like so many instances where before, when the woman actually started living independently, there is a very nice lecture by Srila Prabhupada where he mentions in an interview conversation where a woman actually argues with him, saying that how there are many women who have lived without men, and that's not false. But Srila Prabhupada mentions that where a woman who has lived without men, they still, after becoming pregnant, they have taken like they have not been into a proper protection of a relationship or a marriage, and they were single mothers, and if they did not take, they have not taken the protection of a man, but still they took the protection of the government, the welfare. So Srila Prabhupada's point was that how a woman actually, even if she's working or whatever, she still actually somewhere in her heart desires protection, and she needs the protection by either her husband or the government she's taking or whatever. So this liberation thing, The modern statement of liberation, where she can be independent, is something which many of the women and also some men are fighting about. But if the concept is understood, if a woman is treated nicely or protected very wonderfully from the beginning, where she knows that she has been valued, then this feeling of lack, this feeling of destruction, this feeling of that I want liberation alone will actually never occur. There are so many examples in our scriptures where a woman is like so well educated, Mother Kunti, she has like, there is a book, her teachings, there is a book on her teachings where she has described such wonderful prayers for the Supreme Personality of God, and actually that describes that how exalted of a personality she was, because her prayers are been also worshipped by great saints and liberated personalities. It's because even though she was, if she, you see the quality of Mother Kunti, she was not some kind of like, oh, we want woman liberation or this like that, but she had that sublime quality where she knew that what was the role of a woman, what was her actual role. So this woman liberation is actually about her dependence, her proper dependence, her proper culture, her involvement in taking care, basically it's about for her to fulfill her duties or her role which the Lord has given to her properly. Yeah, there are many times that there is a very wonderful woman and then she's been exploited, and that's why there has to be an education, a proper education, not just a ritualistic ceremony or some kind of a caste system thing, but there has to be a proper education among the society, where a woman should be shown and a man should be shown that what is the value of a woman in society. She can be educated, she can be given a complete education. There is Devahuti, who was like a daughter of a king, and she was so well educated. There is Draupadi, who was like, she was so much well versed about everything. There's so many wonderful examples of women being having education, proper education, but there was also culture, and this culture was what actually defined the real qualities of the woman. Because that it's not the modern education which the woman is going to, or the modern independence which woman is going to implement in the household, is actually this culture. Which gives women different qualities. There is shyness, there is chastity, there is tolerance, there is forgiveness, there is like her artistic works. There are so many wonderful things a woman can do. She doesn't need to imitate like a man. She doesn't need that kind of liberation where she wants to imitate a man, because that's not her role. Her role as a woman is not to be, it's not about being suppressed, it's about being submissive.